A wrestling company is made up of lots of different characters and personas. These can range from babyface heroes who are portrayed as the good guys of the promotion, to the opposite end of the spectrum with heels who need to be disliked by the fans in attendance. Tokyo Joshi is mainly a comedy idol promotion, so all the wrestlers are trying to be as liked as possible, but there is one exception to this. A wrestler whose tall physique casts a dark shadow over Tokyo Joshi. In March 2015, the rose petals scatter on Tokyo Joshi Pro Wrestling. SakiSama makes her first official appearance in the promotion. Many people at first glance would assume SakiSama and Saki Akai are related in some way, and while SakiSama has referred to Saki Akai as her friend, the two are polar opposites and have appeared side by side in magazines, confirming they are separate entities. To the trained eye, SakiSama's differences are prevalent and obvious, such as SakiSama wears black, and look, they have different signatures. But there was an instance where there was some confusion. During a press conference, Yuka Sakazaki mentions Akai looks like SakiSama, and when Akai hears this, she aggressively shushes Yuka. There are three answers to this interaction. Number one, SakiSama and Akai are the same person. Unlikely, but to be fair, all possibilities must be mentioned. Number two, Akai is aware she and SakiSama look similar, but prefers not to be associated with someone so cruel. Or three, Akai was busy that day and so couldn't make it to the conference, so asked SakiSama if she could disguise herself as Akai to not let the fans down. That's the most likely reason. When SakiSama enters the ring, she decrees the girls in Tokyo Joshi aren't pretty enough for her standards, and one by one begins to defeat all wrestlers on the roster. SakiSama values beauty amongst all other things. To her, beauty is strength, and strength is beauty. Her size and dark demeanor makes her an imposing figure in the company, known for comedy and cute idols. What makes her more intimidating is her backstory. SakiSama comes from Renaissance France, a time frame that would make her at least 300 years old. It makes sense, though, given her personality. The aristocracy in France around that time had such disdain for the poor, and there was a huge disparity to those that had status and those that didn't. What's more concerning is her birthday is the 2nd of November, the same as the last Queen of France, Marie Antoinette. Sakisama's power is displayed as she handily beats top stars in the promotion, such as Mio Yamashita and Nonoko. Her power and beauty are able to attract the more vulnerable of the roster, and she's able to make her own faction within Tokyo Joshi, Bishki-gun. SakiSama welcomes new members, actively seeking out wrestlers who are unsatisfied with their current position in the promotion. With the help of Bishki-gun, SakiSama doesn't need to dirty her hands as much, and can begin to take over Tokyo Joshi that much faster. She goes undefeated in the promotion since her first appearance in March 2015 until September that same year, where via a tricky roll-up, the second Princess Cup winner, Shoko Nakajima, is able to pin SakiSama. For the first time, Sakisama's cool front cracks, with her denying the loss. If SakiSama lost, that means she is not strong enough, and if she is not strong enough, she's not beautiful enough either. Upon this realization, she faints, and is carried away by the members of Bishki-gun. When SakiSama returns, she becomes much more brutal than before, determined to secure her status as the most beautiful and the most powerful in Tokyo Joshi. And when she does return, she has new help, her 8-year-old maid, Martha. She starts hitting opponents with roses and using underhanded techniques to get the upper hand on opponents. Despite this clear cheating, SakiSama would deny it if it were ever brought up. But when the tables are turned, SakiSama is quick to get the ref's attention. She also starts to bully weaker roster members more frequently. When SakiSama returns from her frequent trips to France, she would immediately pick out a junior roster member and constantly torment them in matches. She calls them names, attacks with brutal efficiency, and mocks any attempts of them standing up for themselves. But at the same time, SakiSama is especially spiteful to anyone who would deny her requests. When Misao wished to leave Bishki-gun amicably, SakiSama wouldn't have it. You are only allowed to leave Bishki-gun on Sakisama's terms, and if you cross her, she will discard you, but not before making you see the error of your ways for trying to leave SakiSama. And when she attempted to recruit Mizuki to Bishki-gun, Mizuki rejected her. So in the following matches, SakiSama would attack Mizuki with prejudice, and made sure that it was Mizuki who took the pin to prove to her she'd made the wrong move. Some aren't so lucky to escape Sakisama's eyes. Some come under her spell and then join Bishki-gun. These wrestlers either join in a subtle way, with SakiSama tempting them with great power, whilst others are outright kidnapped and reconditioned to serve SakiSama. Aishimizu and Kana were Sakisama's first members to Bishkigun. Aishimizu joined almost instantly with Sakisama, showing a clear adoration for Sakisama. It's unclear if Sakisama was manipulating Ai in any way. Ai was fine with tagging with other wrestlers during Sakisama's absence, and her outfit was never overly regal compared to what she would wrestle in before. But as Bishkigun's first member, she would be considered the measuring stick that Sakisama compared the rest of her followers to. A truly devoted follower who is a formidable opponent to go against. Kana was recruited to Bishkigun when Sakisama sensed her frustration with losing to Miyu time after time. Sakisama tempted Kana with a promise of power, and it was clear Sakisama took great joy in taking one of the founding members of Tokyo Joshi and having them work for her. After joining Bishkigun, Kana's confidence improved and she started to win matches more regularly. But Sakisama left Tokyo Joshi for a time, whilst Kana was still in Bishkigun, so Kana was not able to get the full benefit of working and learning from Sakisama. This made Kana begin to lose matches again, until realizing that pro wrestling wasn't for her, and then retiring. But when she did choose to retire, Sakisama was supportive, and Kana wore her Bishkigun gear and teamed with them one last time, showing it was the most enjoyable time she had in Tokyo Joshi. Martha is more mysterious, even more so than Sakisama. Not much is known where Martha came from, she simply showed up with Sakisama. And despite being an 8-year-old when she debuted, she has strength and technique that either matches or outclasses many of the other wrestlers in Tokyo Joshi. Martha is one of Sakisama's most loyal followers, being prominent in many story arcs over the years. Martha is also very soft-spoken, not speaking on the mic at all, only whispering a few lines to Sakisama so she can speak for her. This isn't too strange though, most 8-year-old girls are shy when speaking to strangers, but Martha is brave enough to stand up for herself. Martha was able to conquer her fear of Maho Kurone when facing the Dragon Bombers, and when Azusa Christie was getting more and more insecure of her standing in Bishkigun, Martha was quick to show that she was not going to be pushed around. Speaking of, Azusa Christie was the first and only member of Bishkigun that Sakisama had forced to join Bishkigun against their own will. Under Sakisama's control, Azusa went from one of the worst win-loss records in Tokyo Joshi to a tag team champion. While the initial results were great, eventually Azusa became more and more manic, costing Bishkigun a few matches. Azusa was 100% devoted to Sakisama at all times, but that same devotion became a double-edged sword. Whenever Azusa would fail, she would strike out even harder for fear Sakisama would abandon her. Eventually, Sakisama had enough and was prepared to re-educate Azusa once more. When Azusa lost in the Bishkigun Civil War, Sakisama was pleased with how Azusa had turned into a fine young lady, and so cut her out of Bishkigun. While this did cause Azusa some stress, she did eventually come to her senses, and after a while she did achieve her dream of becoming married, a goal that she was having difficulty with before joining Bishkigun. Lastly, there is Hyper Misao. Sakisama was surprised when Misao wanted to join Bishkigun, but after seeing the lengths Misao would go, she accepted her. Misao's change was the most dramatic amongst her other followers, being almost unrecognizable in every way, using more vicious moves, including the Vanitas, a move no other wrestler on the roster has kicked out of yet. Misao even changed her name. The character that she went by during this time means chastity and manipulation. Under Sakisama, she was able to capture the tag titles for her first reign and went for the top belt, something she had never done before. However, after losing the belts, Misao began to question herself, and with the help of Rika Tatsumi, Misao broke away from Bishkigun. After leaving, Misao started changing her identity to find her true self and her true power, but as the year went on, she accepted being Hyper Misao, and even became comfortable enough to tap into the dark side and use the Vanitas once more. Misao knows that she can't deny her dark side, as it is still a part of her, and to reject that aspect and bottle it down was the reason she got out of control to begin with. While Sakisama is seen as an enemy in Tokyo Joshi, which is reasonable considering her actions, you can't say that former members are any worse off having joined Bishkigun. In fact, all of them have accomplished goals or come to terms with feelings they've struggled with in the past. But many don't see her as a malevolent therapist for people's personal demons. Sakisama's attitude has created a lot of enemies that have stood up to her over the years. Miyu Yamashita is the ace of Tokyo Joshi and the de facto leader. She has been with the company since day one and defends it when needed. However, when facing Sakisama, Miyu finds it difficult to get any wins over Sakisama. She lost to Bishkigun when they first appeared in a tag match, was betrayed by her former founding member Kana, who then joined Bishigun, and then lost to SakiSama in a singles match, and when going for the tag titles with wrestlers Bishigun had been bullying, was unable to beat Bishigun either. Shoko Nakajima was the first person in Tokyo Joshi to pin SakiSama, and SakiSama has never forgiven her for it. It is one of the few blemishes on SakiSama's perfect record. She got Shoko back by taking the tag title that Shoko worked so hard to achieve, her only championship she had won at the time, and throws it away. The belt in Tokyo Joshi means nothing to SakiSama. She is already perfect, so she doesn't need a belt to confirm it. Whenever SakiSama would win the tag titles, her partner would enter with both championships instead. Rika Tatsumi faced SakiSama on two separate occasions, originally taking on Sin Bishigun to rid Tokyo Joshi of their influence. It took her months of failed attempts with her tag partner Maho Kurone, but eventually she was able to pin SakiSama and rid Tokyo Joshi of SakiSama once more. However, when SakiSama returned, she wanted to get back at Rika. But what did Rika treasure? She had no title belts, and her former partner Maho had left the promotion. It was either luck or fate that Bishigun's next member would be Rika's friend, Hyper Misao. SakiSama gave Misao the greatest change of all her former acolytes, and to really rub it into Rika, Misao joined at her own accord. Rika was forced to fight to not only get rid of SakiSama, but to free her friend by fighting against her and costing her the only championship she had ever held. But eventually, she was able to break through to Misao by showing what true beauty really was. Though SakiSama holds an imposing demeanor and acts selfishly, there are moments where brief glimpses of humanity shine through. These moments usually manifest when dealing with her fellow Bishigun members. An argument could be made that SakiSama is concerned for them the same way someone would be concerned over personal property or material goods, but I'm not so sure. There are points where SakiSama would go out of her way to protect her allies at the expense of her own body. SakiSama would often turn up for Bishigun members' retirement shows as a final farewell, even putting aside grudges with rivals to do what's right for her former Bishigun members, and posing for pictures alongside the other members who she openly stated aren't pretty enough. With someone so obsessed with beauty and her own image, her relationship with her Bishigun members is something much dearer to her. But my favourite example of humanity came at the end of Misao's time with Bishigun. SakiSama had beaten Misao after a hard-fought fight, and thrown Misao her mask, giving her back her old life as SakiSama no longer needed her. Misao responds not by denouncing SakiSama for the horrible things she did under her, but instead thanks her. As tears stream down Misao's face, she thanks her for taking care of her, and for making Misao realize what is best for her, and gives a bow of respect. The show of affection catches SakiSama off guard. Shaken by Misao's response, she looks down, covers her face with her hair, and composes herself. Perhaps if not in front of a crowd, SakiSama would have accepted the gratitude, but to save face in front of everyone, she instead disregards Misao with a poor excuse of only being able to speak French. Hoping that the urchin in attendance can't speak her beautiful language, returns Misao's affection with a bon voyage. And before she leaves, Misao bows once more, SakiSama turning to acknowledge it before leaving the arena. Due to the global pandemic, SakiSama was unable to terrorize Tokyo Joshi for the majority of 2020. SakiSama grew bored with waiting, but without any lackeys to aid her, dominating Tokyo Joshi would be a difficult task. She holds an audition for the latest member of Bishigun, but all the entrants are not to SakiSama's tastes. Losing hope and returning back to France, SakiSama begins to stroll through the woods playing her flute to calm down. And by chance, a young girl heard SakiSama's music and fell under her spell. SakiSama had Martha train her as a maid, and by November of 2020, SakiSama returns to Tokyo Joshi with her new servant, Mei Saint Michelle. But that is a story for another time. SakiSama is one of the most important ingredients in making Tokyo Joshi a fun promotion to watch. So many storylines and other wrestlers revolve around her, whether it be ones that SakiSama takes under her wing in order to build them up, or as a challenge for others to conquer. SakiSama may not be around all the time, but the moments she does show up are beautiful. Thank you so much for watching, and welcome to Season 2 of Tales from Tokyo... Well, I guess I can't call it Tokyo Joshi anymore, because we'll be dealing with another promotion in the next episode. Sorry for the break in the career retrospective videos, and I know this wasn't really a career retrospective, it was more of a character analysis, which I think makes sense for SakiSama, because if you want to hear SakiSama's career, just watch the Kana episode, the Shoko episode, the Dragon Bombers episode, and then the Azusa Takigawa episode in that order, and there's your timeline. So I didn't want to reiterate myself and repeat myself over and over. I wanted to break down the character of SakiSama and what she means and how she affects the inner workings of Tokyo Joshi. I would also like to thank Yuka Sakazaki and Maki Ito for returning and debuting for AEW, so they gave my channel a little more exposure. I'd like to thank all of the people who are subscribed, the people who started out from the beginning, and the newcomers. I hope you enjoy your time here, and enjoy the content I'm putting out. Yep, that's it. That's all I gotta say. So, again, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Ta-ta.